What is up, guys? It is Master Rolf here. Welcome back to Clash of Clans. So before we start, I just want to say a massive thank you. We have hit 69,000 subscribers. We're so close to 70,000 subscribers, so thank you so much for that. A few little things. Yes, my Draw My Life is still coming. I'm still working on it. It's just a lot of work, and I haven't had time really to mow down onto it. But yeah, it's pretty intense. Anyway, today we are going to go onto the single player and see if we can complete it. I've got kind of a mixture of army here, kind of all ready to go, and I hope this is going to work. So I'm going to show you quickly what I've got. I've got one golem, I've got five dragons, I've got five wall breakers, 10 barbarians, and 2 peckers. So the barbarians are kind of suicidal. They're just to clear out any giant bombs. Wall breakers, obviously, to break the walls. Golem is to distract everything while the peckers go in, because I had a look at this base, and I think air defense, there's only 2 air defenses, and once they're gone, we should be able to wipe them clean. So, we're going to give that one a go. But before we start, I've got something really interesting for you guys to talk about in the comment section. Now, please don't be rude in the comment section to start off with, but I have a really funny thing that I would like you guys to know. Now, whenever I get messages, usually lots of them say, I'm a massive fan, etc., etc. And in a video, like, about 2 weeks ago, I said fans, and a few people said, we're not fans, we're just viewers. So I'd love to know what you guys actually think you are. Are you viewers? Are you fans? Are you nothing? I'm just really intrigued, because I don't know technically what to call people, because some people come up to me and say, I'm a big fan, and some people say, I like your videos, I'm a viewer, etc. So I think that'd be something pretty interesting to discuss in the comment section down below. But again, please, do not be rude to each other, just discuss it and whatever. Anyway, onto Pekka's Playhouse. Now, I had to bring the Pekkas, because it is called Pekka's Playhouse. So what we're going to do is we're going to spawn up a few barbarians. I don't quite know what there is, but I think, if I'm not mistaken, oh my god, wow. We're going to like attack from this kind of side bit here, and I'm going to throw in a few of these. I'm going to throw in my golem with 2 Pekkas. And my wall breakers didn't do anything. Literally, my wall breakers have just died straight away, which is kind of depressing. I've got a few archers. The peckers are going around the side. I'm going to raise the peckers up just to make sure that they don't die. I'm actually going to throw that. Should I throw a heal? I'm going to throw a heal down on them as well. I'm going to put my BK in there to do some damage. Hopefully, all right, they've gone for the air defense, which is exactly what I wanted. And now I'm going to spawn up my dragons. Gonna raid my king just to give him back some health, and hopefully, I'm hoping that should be enough. Should this be enough? Now I've taken everything down that I needed to. The dragons should be going around and kind of destroying everything, and we've got 1 star. I really want to get 3 stars, obviously. I'm gonna throw another rage down there, just hopefully to raise those up a little bit. We split into some mini golemites or whatever they're called, which are doing a bit of damage. My Pekkas have been destroyed. I think my Pekkas got destroyed by the Tesla towers, because these are really high-level Tesla towers, and my Pekkas will just get literally obliterated by them. And that looks like we have 3-starred Pekka Playhouse, which actually brings in a massive amount of loot, 700,000 loot to be precise. All right, so let's have a look at our final base. Oh, we've got to actually get our troops ready. All right, I'll just get 1 troop, like, ready, for God's sake. Now we can have a look. So we're going to send 1 barbarian into Sherbet Tower. So this is the hardest one to do. And I really don't know what's going to work against it, because I don't know how many Tesla towers there are in here. It looks like there could be quite a lot. But to be honest, I think a dragon raid could be able to do most of it with a few peckers. So I'm going to throw this down and just see what pops up here. Whoa, just a load of bombs. Okay. I'm sorry, Barbarian. He must have been like, really? Am I actually going in and doing this by myself? Okay, so, with that said and done, we are going to spawn up 2 rage spells and 1 heal spell. We're going to have... Should we have some golem? No, we're not going to. Let's just have a ton of... Should we just try a load of dragons? Let's try a load of dragons in this one. This might work. It might not work. I have no idea. Right, we've got a load of dragons. I'm going to bring in a Pekka with me as well. A couple of wall breakers for that Pekka. And I can bring in something else, but I don't quite know what. Maybe I'll bring in a healer to heal up that Pekka, actually. That might do a bit more. I don't know if that's going to work, but let's give it a go. It could be interesting. It might not work. It might work. God, we've had to use a lot of gems to get this ready. I really want to complete it, but it is super, super hard. I'm sure there's a tutorial that I can watch, that I might have to watch, really. Anyway, I'm going to spawn that up just to get the bombs out of the way. And we are going to spawn in. What I'm going to do is I'm actually going to spawn my dragons right here. And I'm going to raise them straight away. And I'm also going to put a heal spell down as well. Hoping that that will do enough to kind of get to the air defenses. I don't know if it's going to. But let's give that a go. Go on, dragons. Please take out those air defenses nice and quickly. I put the hog riders down as well. Hopefully the hog riders will go through and take out some of the air defenses. Ah, the dragons have fallen-ish. I don't know. Have they fallen? Oh, we've got one star. So we've technically completed it. We have got one star. But it doesn't look like we're going to get any more than one star. I mean, I am quite a low level for probably taking this on. But we've got two stars. I'm happy with that. We have actually completed the single player. Not 100%, not three-starred everything, but we have completed it, and we got a bit of loot from it. How much loot did we take from that? We must have taken... Did we take all their loot? Wow, okay, we actually took all their elixir and pretty much all their gold, so I'm happy with that. That goes down as a win for me. I'm actually really happy with that, and we have now completed single player, but what we'll do is we'll get some more troops ready. I know we have to skip these troops, but we're going to go back and have a look at some of the single-player bases that I haven't destroyed. You know what? Should we just do an all-hog rider raid? I haven't done one of these in a while, and I know you guys love watching all-hog riders. I mean, who doesn't love watching all-hog riders? Let's get all the hog riders up and ready with a load of these. Boom, there we go. And let's have a look at one. So, I've still got these over here. How do I destroy these? I must have to get three stars on this one, and that should go round to there, I think, but... I'm not 100% sure, but let's have a look at Kitchen Sink. So, first of all, it's a really weird name for a base. But we should be okay. Right, let's just spawn them all out. I'm going to spawn them in two places, and I'm hoping that is going to be enough to kind of push them all around. That should be okay. I'm going to throw a rage spell in there as well. Hopefully that will raise them around. And that should be that one, good as gold, completed. Just in case, please, no giant bombs. Yes, no giant bombs. Awesome. Destroy. Wow. Okay, we've had a load of Tesla towers just pop up. But the Hog Riders are just taking those down. Hog Riders are still awesome. I still love them. I know they've been nerfed a lot, but they are still absolutely awesome. And then they're just taking the rest of the loot. So I have, I've got 297 loot to collect. Really, in these should be empty, but there we go. There's the loot that I didn't have. And there's a little bit left in that other one. Go on, Hog Riders. Destroy it. Take that loot for me. Yeah, we're rolling in the loot. There we go. And, oh yeah, of course, the Town Hall. Oh, gosh. Oh, my God. Wow. We could have lost absolutely every Hog Rider right then. And we would have lost it. But we won it just. Literally just. But that's okay. So now we have unlocked a new area. We are going to do a... I'm just going to do a load of all-something raids. And we're basically just going to spend these gems to get this single player finished, hopefully. I'm going to spawn up a load of dragons. And then we're going to spawn up... we're going to spawn up some hog riders with these dragons as well. To take out the air defenses, hopefully. If there is any, they'll take them out. We'll take some raids with us, just in case we need them. Alright, how do I unlock these then? I don't know how I unlock these. Maybe I have to be a higher level to unlock them, do I? Is that correct? I don't know. Somebody tell me in the comment section down below, how do I unlock these? Oh, wait. I haven't gone this way. That's why. That's why. There's a completely different route that I haven't taken yet. Right. So, okay. So, it's good I brought the Hog Riders with me, I guess. I need to take these out with the Hog Riders. That should be enough, I think. Maybe I need to throw another one down or two down. Is that enough? Have I taken those down or what? Right, that's that one taken down. That's that one over there is going to be gone pretty much. Okay, there's one left. Is that going to take him down? Yep. Go on, Hog. Go on, Hog. Oh my God, seriously? That's crazy close. Alright, that should be fine. We'll attack from this side anyway. And we'll spawn them all in. And this should be literally wiped from one side of the base to the other. Let's see if that's enough dragons. I don't even know if we need to rage spell them. We probably don't. I could use one, I guess, in the center here. I'm just going to use one just to speed it up a bit. Go on, dragons. Get that bit of rage going. And kind of wipe it out. My God, they're just annihilating this base. To be fair, there's not really much that we couldn't use not to beat it. It's quite an easy base. We probably could have beaten this one, like, by barging it, to be honest. But dragons are pretty fun to use. I think we've got two more raids we can do. So we'll try two more different raids. And there we have it. We have taken this base out nice and easily. Take out that final bit of gold. And we got our loot back. Nice. Alright. 100%. 150 of each. Alright, so this time we'll use... should we try something like barching? Or I don't know. We'll try something. Let's have a look. See what we've got. We could do a giant healer raid. That might be quite fun. Let's try a giant healer raid. So we're going to spawn up a load of giants. That's a lot of giants. And we're going to spawn up a couple of healers. We're going to throw in a few wizards in there as well. Because I'm hoping the wizards will kind of get the jobs done. One warbreaker and one barbarian. The one lone barbarian. Alright, let's have a look. So this is Crystal Crust. We really should have a look at them before we go in. But that should be fine for what we've got. Go barbarian, what can you do? No, he didn't even get like one touch. Alright, so I'm going to spawn up a few of these. I'm going to spawn up one healer as well. I'm not going to spawn up all the healers straight away. Just in case like we can take out the air defense quite quickly. Alright, they can go in. I'll throw that in. And then I'll put my wizards to go in behind them. So they're like my meat shield, basically. And we can throw in the giants. We got two rage spells. My god, the giants just went flying. There we go. I'm going to put another healer in. Go on, healer. Oh, the healer's just being taken out pretty much straight away. Oh, no, the healer's alright. No, he's not. Healer's down. Healer's down, but the giants have kind of raided this really nicely. And they've actually won it. The all giant and wizard raid worked pretty damn good. It's not all giant, I guess. It's a giant wizard raid. Yeah, well done, giants. Well done, wizards. Wizards are just amazing. Wizards will help any troop out. They are like your best ever companion. Alright, so what other funky raids could we do? What have we got in here? We haven't touched Valkyries for a while. Let's throw a Valkyrie raid together. With... let's have a few wizards, because wizards are cool. And what else should we have? We should probably... Let's have a look. We'll have another load of a few dark troops. We'll have one... Oh, we can't. Damn it. Should we bring him in? And I'll take out one wizard. And then we can have one wallbreaker. Perfect. There we go. That works. So this here is a funky raid that we're doing, actually. It is a... What is it? What raid are we doing here? This is a Valkyrie Dragon Wizard Wallbreaker Golem Raid. Cool. That rolled off the tongue easily. So this one is cold as ice. Alright, so how should we do this one? I think we should spawn up our golem at the start here to kind of take out whatever there is. So we can actually spawn inside the base. I'm going to spawn him in there, and he should kind of take the brunt of stuff. And I'll spawn up a couple of Valks. Yeah, go Valks. Alright, we'll spawn up a couple more. Don't die, Valkyrie. She died. She did. Alright, they're going to take that one out. Once they take out the air defense, I've also got a dragon that I've still got. I've still got one dragon left that I can use. This is actually working alright. I'm going to spawn a couple over that side. And we're going to spawn up our dragon at the back here. Yeah, you didn't expect a dragon, did you? Huh? Did not expect a dragon to come play with you. Oh, do we need another wallbreaker? Nah, we don't need another wallbreaker. They've already broken into the walls. That Valkyrie completely missed the wizard towers. I don't know why, but she did not care about the wizard towers at all. And instead, she's gone for loot. They've all gone for the loot, but they've actually done really well. I've hardly had to use any of them, actually. And it looks like we're going to three-star this base. Look at that golem. Who's going to win? Go on, golem. Yes. Yes, the golem's actually destroyed something on its own. Congratulations. I've hardly ever seen them ever destroy something all by themselves. Alright, let's have a look. We didn't really use much on that one, so we've probably got not too much space left. We haven't used balloons, so let's bring in a load of balloons. We can bring in a couple of peckers. And should we bring in... Let's just bring in some more giants. I quite enjoyed using the giants. I don't know why, but they were actually quite good. Jump around. Let's have a look. So I guess this is going to have a lot of springs. I'm not 100% sure yet. But let's just spawn up one giant and see what happens to him. Okay, the giant's gone down quite quickly. What I'll do is I'll spawn up two giants in there, and I'll spawn up a pecker as well. I would raise them, but I don't know if there's any point, to be honest. You know what? If we spawn them all in there, it's going to be some... I know it's like a trap, but we might be alright. And we can spawn on the outside. We'll spawn a Pekka on the outside. And we'll spawn those. Hopefully, if that takes out that air defense, we can spawn in all our balloons over this side as well, which should... I say should do a lot of damage. Oops, that's all of them. Come on, guys. There we go. Go, Valks. Spawn in the Valks. Spawn them in. And now we can spawn in the balloons, and we'll make everybody rage. Rage it up, my friends. Rage it up. I think this is our last one anyway, so hopefully if we win this, we should be... Oh, did you see all those spring traps around the edge? Literally, the Pekka and the Valkyrie actually sprinted past those spring traps. That was insane. And that should be the end of that. Oh no, we've got one more Archer Tower left. One Archer Tower versus a Valkyrie, a Pekka, and two... the Valkyries just run over spring traps. That's insane. They're way too fast. Boom, perfect. There we go, guys. That is single player completed. I hope you enjoyed today's episode. I thought it'd be fun to run through a load of random raids and just try and defeat some single player bases. Yeah, as I said, we're still close to 70,000, so thank you so much. Let's see if we can get like 1,000 likes on this video. That would be amazing. So if you don't normally like, please do like. For anybody that's asking, yes, there was a hidden code in this one, but it is very hard to find, so good luck. And yeah, hopefully we'll hit 70,000 subscribers and it will be awesome and we'll have another spending spree party and we can do like a big Twitch live stream as well. But until the next episode, guys, thank you so much for watching. Peace out.